Hello guys, today I'm gonna show you how to build and run Docker container with Apache server, which acts like a proxy server with load balancing and sticky session support. So, first of all, we must be sure that on our local machine we have installed Docker and it is running, so just type in your terminal Docker version. If you got version, it means that you have installed Docker on your system. It's a good. So for my demonstration, I have six Docker containers up and running. Just check it. It names server 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It will be used for load balancing demonstration. Now I'll get its IP addresses. Where is my command? Here it is. So, here we see IP addresses of each container. And now we will go to Docker Hub. Okay. Explore. And look for Apache server. It has name httpd. Here we have official releases. Open it, and these are the versions of different versions of the same Apache server. Here we see how to create a Docker file. Just type in from httpd and then version. So I maybe will use this version with Alpine operating system. Okay, now I created a demonstration for demonstration folder on my desktop, so just navigate to my empty folder, desktop Docker Apache demo. It is empty. I may open it. Yes, it is empty folder. And now let's create a Docker file. So we Docker file, open it, and like we have information here, just type in from httpd and pick up our version. It will be 2.4.27 Alpine. Okay, so next command will be run. We may run Alpine operating system update. It will be apk update and apk, let's add Midnight Commander for easy directory exploring, and Apache 2 and Apache 2 proxy. That's it. Now we save our Docker file and here it appears. Let's make an empty directory for source files. Make dir src. Okay, we have empty directory for our source file, and for now we may build and run our Docker container from Docker files. So just type docker build current directory. It will look for Docker file, and if it found it, it will build our image. So let's start. Step 1 and step 2. Okay, now we have our image created. Here it is a tag for our image. Let's copy it and now type a command docker build, give a name for our container. Let's be proxy demo, detachable mode, port for local machine 80 will redirect to container port 80, and our container name. Unknown flag name, It's very strange. Docker, okay. Sorry, this is not Docker build, it will be Docker run, because we already built this image. Okay, enter. And let's check Dockerfile. Yes, we have proxy demo container up and running. So we can reach it by Docker exec ti proxy demo, and let's say bash. Okay, here we are in inside our Docker container. As you remember, we installed Midnight Commander, so just type Midnight Commander, and up, we are here. What we need next? We need next to Apache configuration files. So let's go to configuration httpd.conf. All we need to do, just close Midnight Commander, cat httpd.conf. Now let's clear our terminal and now type in cat httpd.conf, and here we have configuration file of our Apache. Sorry, okay, I'll found the start. Okay, we started from here, so let's copy this all httpd configuration file. Yeah, okay. Come here, copy it. And exit from our container. And create the same configuration file in our source directory. So let's cd to source directory. Yes, we are here. And the httpd configuration file. Cert paste. Right. Let's check source. Yes, we have original httpd configuration file. We will modify it later, but for now let's repeat steps to get another original configuration files. So one more time, just log in to our proxy demo container, go to configuration. And now we will need in extra folder a few files. So it will be proxy HTML configuration file and HTTPD vhost configuration file. So do the same. Okay, clear here. Cat HTTPD vhost configuration file. Not so large at first. So from here, just copy it, log out from our container, exit. We must be in source directory. Let's create httpd with a hosts conf file. Okay, save it and check again. Yes, we have httpd with host configuration file. Repeat the step again for the last one. So enter inside the Docker container, Midnight Commander, configuration extra folder, and let's get proxy HTML configuration file. So clear, cat proxy HTML configuration file. And it's starting from here. And I think it over here. Okay, copy, exit inside cert c, we and it will name proxy HTML file and paste it here. Okay. Now we have copied from our original Apache server configuration files, now source directory, and now we will modify it. So for now we don't need any more running proxy demo image, so we just can docker stop Apache proxy, sorry, proxy demo, oh sorry, okay, proxy demo, and we can even remove this container from our list, docker remove proxy demo. Okay, clear. So first of all we need to uncomment some lines in httpd configuration file. So vhttpd configuration file, and here I have just a quicker propose what the must to uncomment. So let's see. First of all, we need to uncomment these lines 1180, 137, and so on. So I don't see lines here. It's a little bit tricky, will be, but try to find. So first line, mod proxy HTML. We're looking for mod proxy HTML. Here I found it, mod proxy HTML. So we just uncomment it. Second will be mod proxy. It will be mod proxy. Second mod proxy connection, it will be this one. Second will be mod proxy HTTP. HTTP, and then mod proxy balancer. Mod proxy balancer. Mod slot mem. Mod slot mem on command. Then there'll be 163, 164, 165, 166. So it will be here 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And at the end of the file, the must.comment virtual host section. So let's go to the end of file. Okay, it will be somewhere here, virtual host. Here it is, uncomment virtual host. It will include in configuration extra folder HTTP host configuration file, and also uncomment HTTPD default configuration file. It will be various default settings. Okay, uncomment. That's it. We've done the modification of this file, so let's save it. I close it, it doesn't need any more. So what's next? Let's make a few files for applications which we like to route users and make a load balancing. So I will create app1 conf file and we'll write insert balancer member http, and as you remember we will provide our server's IP address, so let it be fast load balancing member starts from 02, then balancer member HTTP 03 and balancer member HTTP 04. This is our test application file, and make for second application the same, app2conf and balancer member HTTP 172.17.0.2.3.4.5 balancer member HTTP 17.0.6 and 0.7. So that's it. We have here app1, app2 configuration file which keeps load balancing members. We have a modified httpd configuration file, so left only two files unmodified. So let's modify the first one. It will be httpdb with config. Httpd with host config. And what we must do edit here, just to provide information about virtual host. Let's delete these all sections. Okay, this doesn't need for us. And now here insert some information. So for sticky session support, we must add header add set cookie route ID will be balancer worker route, just type the same information like I, and if you want to know more about setting cookies, you can Google it. Okay, for sticky session support, they added this line. Next line, we just write our balancer's name, so proxy pass, let's say app1. It could be any application. You just give it the right name, and balancer name will be the same app1. Next line, proxy pass reverse app1 balancer the same app1, and for second application the same information, just different naming. So let's say app2 balancer will be app2 proxy pass reverse app2 balancer app2. That's it. We can save this file. And the last one, modify proxy HTML config file. So proxy HTML config file. Go to the end of this file. Okay. And at the end of this file, just add some new information. So first of all, it will be if modular mod proxy C. Okay, let's say proxy request will be off, proxy via will be off, proxy reserve host will be on. And now write some information about our proxy balancers. So proxy balancer app1 okay, let's say just leave it commented sticky session support proxy set sticky session equal route ID and include user local touch to conf extra app1 configuration file. Let's close proxy and do the same thing for our second proxy balancer. It will be proxy balancer app2, the same proxy set sticky session equal route ID and include second file, include user local Apache 2.conf extra app2 conf. This is these two files which we created earlier, so close the bracket, cross the modular section. If modular. And let's add a balancer manager. It will help us to track if our load balancer works correct. If modulum mod proxy balancer, add if modulum mod status C location USB balancer manager. And set handler balancer manager order demi allow. Let's say allow from all right now and satisfy all. Close the location and close the model. That's it. We done our modification to the last file. Save it. And now we must to modify Docker file to copy these our newly created files to the Docker image on the build step. So let's up one directory and modify our Docker file. So we Docker file and add copy steps to copy these newly created files. I'll say copy, and our file which we need to copy lays in a such directory, and it's a httpd.conf file we want to copy to inside a Apache container to location user local Apache 2 configuration directory and give it the same name httpd.conf file. And let's copy the left sources. So copy source and httpd the hosts conf directory, not directory but file. Another file source proxy html conf file and two files app1 and app2. So source app1 conf and source app2 conf, and all these files we copy to the directory user local Apache 2 conf extra directory. All these files will be copied inside the Docker container of this directory. So we're done with modification. Let's save it. And now we can try to build our image. Command will be Docker build on the current directory. Go. Okay, successfully build. And now we want to run our image. So I'll copy the last tag of my newly created image and Docker run. Give it a name, Apache proxy. You can give any name as you want. Let me detachable mode. Let's open ports on local machine 80 inside Docker container 80. Paste in created image tag and go. Okay, let's check. Is it up and running? No, it's not up and running. I don't know what's going wrong, so I'll check out and come back. Just find out what's going wrong. So to check logs from Docker container, we can type command docker logs and give it a name Apache proxy, and here we see what's going wrong. So first of all, we need to enable mod proxy html. it is enabled, but it requires mod XML 2 and C. So we must edit HTTP d.conf file and enable this modular. And the second problem is syntax error in the app2 configuration file, just mistype. So let's go and edit it. Cd to SRC. Okay. V app2 conf. And yes, here are mistype just. Let's fix it. Okay. And edit httpd conf. We need to enable mod XML. Okay. Mod XML. Let's find it. Yes, here it is. Enable it. Save. And let's try do the same steps. So, Docker build. Okay. Then Docker run. Oh, sorry, we must remove existing Apache proxy container because we can create with the same name. So, Docker remove Apache proxy. Okay, and now Docker run name Apache proxy detached mode port 8080 and our okay. And now let's check the PS. Yes, it's now up and running and we can log in. But actually we don't need login because it's on the local machine on port 80. So we might just check right now and type localhost. Yes, Apache server works and running. And now let's check how works our load balancing. So if I'll type localhost slash app one, it will open server one. I just refresh the page, it opens server two. I'll refresh again, it opens server three. And 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. As you see, it works as load balancing, and if we check our balancer manager, we here have some information and statistics. So our app 1 balancer contains 3 IP addresses and it loads traffic between these 3 servers. So elected 3 times. So each time I'll go to app 1, it balance the traffic to keep works everything great. Okay, we can check our app 2. We can have many apps as we want, so let's check app 2. It must work the same way, just different servers. App 2 server 4, server 5, server 6. 4, 5, 6. As you see, we have working load balancing. And if we refresh this information, we got elected 6, 5, 5 time, 4, 3, 3 time. Now, for the end of this video, I want to show you that sticky session support works as well. So let's modify our configuration file. Okay, I'll close it and close it. And now Docker stop Apache proxy. Okay. Name it docker remove Apache proxy. I'm in demo, so cd to src. I'm in src, okay, and let's modify our. We have here modify proxy HTML configuration. Go to the end of file. And just uncomment proxy set for app 1 and proxy set for app 2. That's it. Put up and do the Docker build again. Okay. Do the Docker run. Again, let's check, is it running? Yes, it's up and running. And now localhost works. And now app 1, go server 1, refresh the page, still server 1, refresh the page. Server 2, refresh page, server 3, refresh. It doesn't work as I expect, so let's check balancer manager. Maybe we have just cache, so 2-1-1. Sticky session route ID. Okay, I forgot something. So let's back here. Stop the Apache proxy and remove it. What I forgot, it's to modify cdsrc. To modify app 1, app 2 configuration file, and let's modify app 1 configuration file. I forgot to mention that when you turn on sticky session support, you must provide here some information. Let it be route ID, so like this. Route ID equal 1, this is route ID equal 2, this is route ID equal 3, and do the same thing with app 2 configuration file. Okay. Route ID equal 1, 2, 3, let be 4. Doesn't matter. 1 route ID equal 2 route ID route ID equal 3. And now let's check, does it help? I think it helps. So Docker build. Now Docker run name Apache proxy detach port 8080 image tag check in backup. Yes, no, it's not working. Let's check Docker logs Apache proxy unknown worker parameter balancer unknown worker parameter. Okay. App 1. What it is a known worker parameter? It's very strange. Okay, I'll come back in a few seconds. Okay, I figured out where the problem was, so I don't know why, but it don't like the same name for routing as the set the cookie. So just we need to modify not route ID equal one, but just route equal one, route equal two, route equal three, and do the same thing with app do. App2 configuration file, also just route equals 1, route equals 2, route equals 3. And now, okay, just build the same again, so docker build. Just copy this one. Now just do docker run command. Okay, and now check Docker. Yes, it's up and running, and now we can check localhost works, app 1, server 1, refresh server 1, refresh server 1, refresh, refresh, and now you can refresh anytime, but you will be redirected to server 1 because now support of sticky session is turned on. And the Apache proxy server recognizes your browser, identifies you as the same user, and each time you try to access app 1, you will be redirected to the same server. We may check that balancer manager now shows that you first time was redirected to this server, and each time you try to access app 1 application, you will redirect to the same session. It's selected time 8 times. The same thing will work with let's say application 2. App 2, first time we got into server 4, so each time many will try to reach, they will be redirected to the same server. And that's like sticky session works. So I think that's it. We got a working Apache server as a proxy server on Docker container. And also I show you how to turn on sticky session supports. Hope that you like my video. Please press like and see you with the next videos. Bye-bye.